final rest on the car. The day was tanked up. And ever is a handicap hurdle. And as usual, our first point. Number one on the car.
On the 16th of June 1988, Mr. James Lemming visits the Ascot racecourse for the first time in his life. He bets all his money. The public are betting the favourite, but Lemming already knows that this horse, Il de Cifra, is not going to win.
Down at an 11 storm at that. And who knows it?
One
or seven. Come in, you will. Well, they four to Mandeville.
342.
Land Acres, 342. Bones, £28 a trade in there, thank you. Lord Dorset, 22 and 2 place, ticket number 90.
He places a bet for £14,982. Lemming was a nervous wreck. The ticket in Mr. Lemming's hand will earn him £453 for every single pound betted. 14,982 times 453. 18,000. No, 14,000. 892 times 400. Plus another 50, plus 3. But first, 400 times 14. Mr. Lemming arrived at the racecourse later than planned.
And then right on their heels, sailed by the stars, Irish Dan.
He had some difficulty reaching the spot he had in mind, 20 yards from the finish.
As they make the turn right at the bottom end of the course. Six more fences to jump, four up the hill, turn the home straight, and Danger Baby takes them along still. Food Hill, Sandy, nicely on the inside.
Go on, Lord.
Sailed by the stars on the outside. Four Irish Dan in between them in five. And then Belmont King at the back. Up now to the ditch. Danger Baby.
Mr. Lemming's binoculars had been altered.
To measure it. Still rounds too clear.
They contained no lenses. In order for him to aim, he had to look over them. Thank you. the industrial battery in the pocket of his raincoat, supplied just enough power to produce an ultrasonic gong stroke from the piezoelectric transducers that Mr. Lemming had hidden in his binoculars. The crowd did not notice Mr. Lemming turning the switch between the battery in his pocket and the ray gun. £6,746,076 came to his mind in a split second. No one heard the sound blast that Mr. Lemming fired at the horse. Only seconds, yards before victory, Ilda Seifler appeared to be struck by lightning. A South London car dealer, who claims he invented an ultrasonic stun gun, which was used to stop a racehorse winning at Royal Ascot, told a jury yesterday how he tested a prototype of the device on horses in fields near Woking, Surrey. James Lemming, 49, said that he aimed the device disguised in a pair of binoculars at several horses, and that when fired from 20 feet or so, the animals shot off.